Hello, this is the infamous Iffy. So I looked up what you're supposed to do with the graveyard puzzle, and it's quite a bit tricky, actually. I wouldn't have figured it out on my own. So first off, you're supposed to equip the broken relic. I knew the broken relic was for something because it was in the shop, but I would have thought maybe it was just for something later in the game, or I don't know, anything else. But anyway, you also seen in the video you get tips from these three, like up, left, down, and the other one. So apparently I was right as well. There is a secret boss for this. Wasn't expecting that. I was expecting it to just be like a few coins or something. So up, left, down, and then right. Oh no. Up, down. Okay, it's connected to these three anyway. Maybe it's different each time. Let's see. Left. Left, right, down. Left, right, down, left. Okay. So, left, right, down, no. Left, right, down. Yeah, I've got the item equipped. Different for each person. When they say left though, which one do they mean? I left him in the dust. So left, right, down. Left, right, down, left. Okay, maybe it means each row. Right, left, right, down, left. Yeah, really not understanding this. Got it! Okay. So that was really confusing. So that was left, right, and then down left. Okay, I was wondering which direction it was going to be from. Okay, take a little nap. May as well. Yeah, fighting these boss fights are really difficult. Time to sleep. Oh, the clock's broken. Okay. It's kind of weird this is a dream. Is this supposed to be like a dream of the devil we beat in the first island, the main story? Yeah, these were from the boss fight in the final. Okay, so you can stand on the ground at least. Yeah, this is Cuphead's hell, alright. Trapped in an endless boss fight. Wait, can I just... can just stand on the edge. Hang on, let me just... No, you can't. That was working for quite a while there. Wow, this is really tricky. So, is it when I shoot them that makes them real? A lot to dodge here. I wonder, can I just... Do I have to have the broken relic equipped to use this? Or can I cheat this and... Not cheat it, but... Twin heart? Oh! You can. So the broken relic was just really to unlock the pathway. I wish it stopped switching, because it's making it difficult to keep track of which one to go after. Like, why does that switch to... Do they just switch at random, or is there any control I have in this? Because that's just switching so fast, I can't even see. Oh, so if I look at it... So the one I'm looking at will disappear. Yeah, they switch based on turn. Fireballs are annoying. Okay. Okay, so the angel one's actually helping you. I'm supposed to parry on them without looking at them. This is awkward. Yeah. Not liking the secret boss much, because... Let me just see how much damage this would do. Okay, so it is working, but it's like really slow. Yeah, this fight is really, so it's all about time consuming. There's just nowhere safe to stand though. You've just gotta like keep dodging everything and hope for the best. Like, the only control I have is which side they're gonna be. That doesn't help much. Yeah, that doesn't help much with the projectiles. Okay, I have more of an idea now. If I can get on that platform in the center, maybe if I duck. Just gotta like pick the perfect time to get on it though. Damn it, getting on this platform is really tricky as well.
Thank you.
Okay, over halfway. So it makes the projectiles disappear as well. Damn it. Just a lot to remember for this fight. Wow, this is really tricky. Thank you. Starting to wonder, would the spread, the chaser shot be better for this? Yeah. Might switch to the chaser. Just because the spread doesn't do damage. Yeah, it's good if you can cut close to the target. Also, I don't want the ghost one. I want the energy beam. I'm not sure if Miss Chalice would be better for this. Yeah, Chaser's a little bit better. Close was I? Oh, so close. I thought that must be quite close to the end. Yeah, taking a hit on the first bit there, no. Thank you. If I could get to level 5 cards, you're finished. Got ya! Yeah, as soon as you got to level 5 cards, you're finished. Dead. Take that, unwanted nightmares. Stay dead in the main campaign where you belong. Could it be? Fabled cursed relic, long fought, lost to time, awoken at last. It despises bravery, okay. Oh, and that's nice. For all that hard work, you don't get anything. I was expecting like an item or something. Oh well, at least no more nightmares for Cuphead. Yeah, to be honest, I was thinking about giving up on that boss. But now I was thinking, is this really that too difficult? But with the spread shot, I wasn't doing much damage at all. But with the chaser, that made that a lot more easier, bearable. Because the spread shot, just like I was, and I wasn't sure with the direction at that point as well when I was playing earlier. Like I learned about the direction, like if you change direction, it changes the thing later on. Made that a lot easier at the end there as well. Like I got through that last part quite easy when it just by keeping switching it up. But yeah, the chaser shot really helped out a lot there. I'm sad that there's no reward though for that. It's a nice secret boss though. case, may as well switch back to the spread shot now. I will keep the chaser on though, because it is very useful. So, I'll try the final boss without the extra hits. If there is a final boss, or is it just going to go straight to the ending? Oh, what happens if you do this again? Oh. Okay, exit to map. So yeah, that's just the tutorial again. Then again, thinking about it, I might want the extra hit points. So yeah. Depending on what happens next, if it's the ending, if it's just going to be the ending, or is there anything extra going to happen? Anyway, let's see what happens. Salt Baker's Bakery. Okay. Oh, he's gone. Okay, so where was the Wonder Tart he was going to make? Okay. Can I go back out? Feels like I just walked into a Tales from the Crypt episode. Is the Crypt Keeper going to be down here? Okay. Welcome back, you meddlesome brats. I didn't think you'd be back so soon. No, Matt, it's too late to stop me now. The Wonder Tart will be my finest work yet. Okay, so this basically the chef's the final boss. I can tell by the crazy eyes. Chairman, never told you about the most important secret ingredient. Oh, a living soul. Why you suckers weren't doing my bidding, I nabbed your friend here. Okay, when? So, at what point was that? Because we only just made it back. When her soul is baked into the Wonder Tart, the cosmic powers of the astral plane will be mine. It must have been very quick, like when did he grab Miss Chalice? Cuphead, Mugman, you gotta help me. But first, I'll take those ingredients, and then I'll use your heads as serving dishes. Don't think so. Yeah, good thing I came with extra hit points. Had an idea there was gonna be something at the end. Okay. Okay.
Good game.
Oh, he's powering himself up. Okay, this is different. Okay, made it to the second phase. Okay, so even the leaves can hurt you in this part. Try not to take a hit on the first 5 seconds.
Now go!
Yeah, the cucumber and this flame are the worst. Come on. Now go. A broad is currently brewing. It's on. A great plan and stuff. It's on. The flame that's the worst, and the cucumber. Okay, that was a disaster. Wow, that throws so much at you, it's like hard to dodge everything. This flame, I wish it would stop following. Oh, come on. How was I supposed to know that was going to... Wow, all three objects closing in at once. Now go. A brawl is truly brewing. Now go. A great slam and stop. And begin. Yeah, this first phase goes on for a real long time. Forgetting about the flame. I hate how the flame can come in at any point. Everything else is not that bad. Oh, so you can dodge some of the cucumber if you duck. Okay. So by ducking, you can dodge some of the cucumber. It's on. This part is really annoying because. If that flame would stop jumping around, it wouldn't be too bad.
Thank you.
any more hits. Come on. Wow, that second phase goes on a long time as well. Oh, come on.
Thank you.
Oh, third phase. Well, didn't even see what that one was. First and second phase seem the worst so far. Just due to the amount you have to dodge. Flame's the worst, just because it chases you. And as I'm trying to dodge all this other stuff, the flames just keeps getting in the way. I can't even get over that part. You're Wow, how was I supposed to even dodge that? Kept going up and down. Keep forgetting about the cucumber at the bottom as well. What? What the hell am I supposed to do there? Because you can't jump, because I would have hit the cucumber.
A great plan and enough. You're up. Good day for a well battle. Now go.
Wow, the amount of like obstacles on that last part there, you just wanna... Thank you. And died.
A brawl is currently brewing. And begin!
I might want to change it up a little bit. Take off the spread. While the spread's good, it's not really helping here because sometimes he's too far away. I'm not sure if the pea shooter would be better. Try the crack shot out, maybe that's good. Do I have to go through the dungeon again, or does it? Oh, it takes you straight to the boss. Okay, that's good. Okay, this is a little bit better. The crack shot is... Does it have to do all three at once? The cucumber, the sugar cube, and the flame. Yeah, the crack shots definitely does a bit more damage. I just wish this second part wasn't difficult as well. Glad I bought the crack shot as the last power up I got for the coins. Thanks, game. To the final phase there, nearly. Oh, best time. That was the best time I could have used that level 1 super there. Okay, got through level phase 2 without, well, I was about to say without taking a hit. I took a hit, but still got 4 HP left. Okay, what now? I probably should have saved that for the... this whatever's coming next, shouldn't I? Ah, come on, how close was I? Ah, so close. Too many hits. Thank you. Got ya! Took a bit of figuring out, but did it. Ah, that was tricky. That. Well, it wasn't really that part. It was the first phase and the first phase and the second phase that were the tricky parts. A minus, not bad. Yeah. Crackshot and the chase. Both those ones really helped out there. Crackshot especially. Because Chaser was doing good, but it wasn't doing enough damage. Where Crackshot did that little bit more damage. Just to get through phases earlier. I like how Chef Baker is at the back, just Salt Baker is just like, damn it! Why? Yeah, he fooled them. Okay, bye Salt Baker! You've seen the entire bakery crumble. Oh, he's getting out as well. Ah! No, my bakery! Damn you, Cuphead! Serves him right for duping us. But with the bakery destroyed, you're never gonna get that wonder tart. I like this ending more than the main story ending. The main story ending was great, but this one's a lot better. Well, both endings are great, but this one, I like this one a bit more. Just that Chalice didn't care in the end. Oh, so Salt Baker went to prison? / farming? I like this comic book strips. How they've done this. For the end credits. Yeah, just like the main game though, that was a nice ending. Oh, this is a song all about his bakery. Oh, so patch things up in the end with Cuphead. Grand reopening. Okay, I'm just gonna skip the credits now. I just wanted to see what the epilogue was. So, anything extra, or is that it? Gonna go back to the story again, see if anything was added. Okay. Yeah, so I guess that's the end. Gotta say, this game and the main story have been, it's been a blast playing through all of Cuphead. The main story I enjoyed this DLC as well. I thought it was a bit short, being that there was only about 5 bosses, but I forgot, I was forgetting about the King's ones as well. Each of them were bosses. So in all, there was about 11 new bosses, 11 to 12, which were all great. I enjoyed this DLC, even though it was a bit shorter than the main campaign, just as much as the main story. In fact, some of the bosses were a lot more entertaining in the DLC. Like, the bosses were great in the main campaign, but I don't know, they seemed the bosses in this seemed a lot of more fun. Like, a lot more fun with the amount of stuff you had to dodge and the projectiles and just each boss's different patterns. As said, I really enjoyed this DLC and the delicious last course and enjoyed the story of it. I think I would say I enjoyed the story of the DLC. I enjoyed the main campaign a lot. The main campaign was amazing, but the DLC, I would say I enjoyed it a bit more. Just a little bit more than the main campaign. I liked how it told the story at the start and just had a great ending to the whole thing. With Chef Saltbaker being a villain at the end, but then in the epilogue, turning good again. Anyway, not sure what game I'm going to play next. I have to think about it for a while, but really enjoyed Cuphead both Cuphead and the delicious Last Course DLC. And I hope in the future there'll be a Cuphead 2. That's all I can say. So anyway, thanks for watching. That last boss fight, I just want to say as well, that was the hardest out of the 10 so far I faced, the Saltbaker one. Yeah, that was definitely the most difficult. I would say even it was more difficult. I'm not sure which was more difficult, the secret boss, the devil one, or the Saltbaker one. The devil one, though, once I figured out what to do there, that was easy. The Saltbaker one was genuinely really, really that bit more difficult. The final boss. So, anyway. Thanks for watching, and until the next game I play, next time, bye.